I think there are a couple of things to it. There is the innovator themselves. I think one thing that is very important is that they focus on the ID and making the ID work, rather than think immediately about making money or becoming famous or anything. If I talk about myself, when I had the ID for Eduroam, I had never ever dreamed about it becoming a big success. I was trying to solve a problem, and I think that is what innovators should look at, solving real world problems. And sometimes that's small, sometimes it's bigger, but in the end it should be about that and not about where do I think the next millions will be spent. The other dimension of it is making it possible for people with bright new ideas to bring them to fruition. If you look at the internet the way it came to be, it is very much about that. There is this concept called permissionless innovation, and that is nobody has to help you in getting access to the network, publishing your application, things like that. You can just do it. And that is one thing that I am concerned about. With the internet having become very commercial, there are many organizations and bodies that try to control what is happening on the internet, try to make sure that nothing happens that they don't previously approve of. And I think that is a collective thing for all of us, to make sure that the internet remains a place where you can bring your ideas to fruition without asking anyone if you're allowed to. Let the consumers decide whether something is successful or not. Yeah, so how did the internet evolve since 2002-03 when we were starting with Eduroam? I think the big difference is that the internet has become ubiquitous. I remember back in those days, it was the time when people would proudly tell me that they now had an email address. Nobody now tells me anymore that they got an email address. They probably are born with an email address. So in that respect, the world has become connected. And what you see is that the world has become connected also in our environment. So research really has become global. It used to be that there was a group of researchers tucked away somewhere in a few rooms in the cellar of a university, and they were doing things. And then a few times a year they would come out and write an article and talk at a conference, and that was it. And that has completely changed. Collaborations are now global. You collaborate with researchers across the world, and what Eduroam has enabled is that you don't need any help administratively to get access to the network wherever in the world you are. And if I can add to that, the same we're now seeing is also with identity federations, where the same thing is happening for access to other resources than just the network. So the combination of identity federations and Eduroam really allows students and researchers to get always and everywhere and at any time connected to the resources they need to get access to. And I think that is the main result of having Eduroam and identity federations. Advice for innovators. I think I would use three words that have been used in another context and by another company. Just do it.